In this session, we are going to discuss about an overview of microelectromechanical systems. What is microelectromechanical systems? Micro in the sense, we are going to fabricate a device whose size is of micrometers. That is the main reason behind this microelectromechanical systems. We will call it as a MEMS. An abbreviation of this is MEMS. Micro in the sense, it is micro. Electromechanical system in the sense, it is going to be a system. That system is going to have both electrical components as well as mechanical components in the same fabrication surface. That is a basic view about microelectromechanical systems. It is a forehead of a linear integrated fabrication circuit. In linear integrated fabricated circuits, we will construct a small size devices whose size is of somewhat greater than micrometer, but we will not use all the accessories in the same monolithic components. But here we will fabricate all the devices in the same monolithic component. That is the main reason we get microelectromechanical systems. So, Jess, what is the necessity to construct microelectromechanical system? For everything, for every system, what we are going to create, it should not be of simply sensing a particular parameter. So here we are going to fabricate a microelectromechanical system whose work is to sense and actuate. What is the difference between a sensing and actuation? A sensing is how we will see a thing. That is called sensing. What is meant by actuation? One form of energy that is to be converted into the other form, that is called actuation. That's what we are going to discuss here. So microelectromechanical system, major objective is to sense and actuate. That is the one line objective of microelectromechanical system. But this is of very compact. It can undergo batch processing. It has more merits when compared to the linear integrated fabrication. That is the merit of microelectromechanical systems. So you can see here all the components, all the components can be fabricated inside the same circuit. And also you can see the last line. What is it mentioned here? The sizes of micrometer, the future sizes of micrometer. That is the major merits of microelectromechanical systems. The next you can see the ranges. The ranges of what is the position of microelectromechanical system? We just see what is the smallest object or smallest particle in the world is an atom. A cell, an atom. So it has a unit of angstrom. The next is nanometer. What is an angstrom? 0.1 nanometer is nothing but an angstrom. So this is a smaller thing. And we have categorized overall system present in the earth through three categories: nanotechnology, microsystems, mesosystems, and macrosystems. We are now discussing with nanotechnology. Its goal is somewhat more negative microelectromechanical system. We are not in this stage, but we are in the stage of microsystems. Meso, macro. Macro is people's. Mesosystem is somewhat greater than micrometer, or it will be in the range of 100 millimeter, like that. It will be of greater than micrometers. But what about microsystems? A microsystem in the range will be of 0.1 micrometer to somewhat greater than 10 micrometer. This is coming to microsystems. But every atom will have a differentiation of this size. It will not be fixed at 0.1 to 10 micrometer. It will be of micrometer, but every other will give different perspective over this size. So this is the basic. The next is, what makes the MEMS to become very attractive in compared to linear integrated fabrication? That is because of the materials what we are using here. The materials what we are using is polymer, compound, inorganic, as well as other semiconductors. What is the merit of using these materials? We have discussed in our physics about stress, strain, Young's modulus. What is the necessity to define these parameters? Stress, strain, Young's modulus. Young's modulus in the strength. Young's modulus in the strength. It is a ratio of stress by strain. So whenever there is a change in stress or whenever there is a change in strain, even E will depends upon it. But E depends upon the device geometry. It depends upon some other parameter also. Just listen. So polymer material which has variety of that material is available in variety of Young's modulus. That is the major merit of polymer material. It is not available to simple with one numerical value of E. That material can be fabricated with numerical. It has more polymer materials are available. Example, polyamide, fluorocarbon, polymethyl, meta acrylate, PDMS, SU8. There are so many material, polymer materials that are available, which has larger value of RE, which will give us larger values of E and difference in E. The next is compound semiconductors. You know about semiconductor. That is silicon, germanium, or semiconductor materials. But call the three, the merits of MEMS as three MEMS. These are the three major merits of MEMS component: miniaturization, microelectronics integration, and mass fabrication. What is meant by miniaturization? Miniaturization in the sense, you all know, we are calling it as microelectromechanical system. In the sense, the device will be of very compact. So that is the main reason of miniaturization. Sticking due to the interaction between air as well as water particle. these are the parameters.